You guys, guess what today is? Today is Albinism Awareness Day.
That's right, June 13th. I've forgotten it every single year, but this year I swore I would not forget. So today, I'm sitting here to, as the name entails, spread some awareness. But through what? Oh, okay, sunscreen. More sunscreen. Makes sense. Oh, my glasses. All right. Bad jeans. Valid. Skin is white as paper. Oh, some more sunscreen. Yeah, makes sense. It's June. And my inability to catch things. But seriously, today I'm going to answer the question, what the heck is albinism? Okay, so brief intermission, sorry to interrupt, but about my last video, thank you guys so much for all of your compassionate responses. It was heartwarming, and just thank you so much. If you haven't seen that video, you should totally go check it out. I've heard it's pretty cool. So it's in the card, and it's also going to be in the description, and it's called Dear High School, Here's the Disability, puns, I'm Blind, Get Over It. It's more serious than this one, but it's definitely informative, and you should go check it out. Anyway, into the fun stuff. So first I'm going to start with, why do I even have albinism? Did I wake up one morning looking like I rolled in too much powdered sugar? Like, what's going on here? None of that. So actually, albinism is a recessive genetic mutation slash disorder. So I'm going to break that down. Both of my parents had to have this super duper rare genetic mutation, which is like a genetic accident. So they both had to have that. And then they both had to pass it to me. And because it's recessive, it doesn't show in them. They just are carriers of it. So all of these things considered, albinism is extremely rare, and the chances of me getting it were like 1 in 20,000, so I really just lucked out on this one, guys. So yeah, then I popped out and the doctors were like, wow, she's a marshmallow, and then my parents did research, and now I'm going to talk about what albinism is and how it affects me. Okay, so when it comes to albinism, there's two main types. There's ocular albinism and oculocutaneous albinism. And of course, I have the one that is like impossible to say. So ocular albinism is when it just affects your eyes and not the way you look. However, oculocutaneous albinism is what I have, and so that affects my eyes, like how I see, as well as how I look. So starting with the way that I look like a ghost, and I make a lot of jokes about it. Basically, my hair, skin, and eyes are super white because albinism, the gene mutation, affects like the enzymes that make the pigment that give your skin, hair, and eyes color. So another like byproduct of that is that I have to wear a lot of sunscreen, I get sunburned super easily, and I do not tan because melanin slash pigment is what your skin uses to like protect from the sun's UV rays and what you get tan from. So I don't have any of that, so your girl's gonna be pasty forever. My hair also has no pigment, so it grows out of my head looking like this, like extremely white. Now, I did add some blue and purple to it, but yes, it grows out white like this. I just fill in my eyebrows and like put on mascara because I like brows, you know? My eyes also have no pigment, so they change color from gray, blue, purple. I think it's pretty cool. I don't mind it. Something else about my eyes that kind of gets into now the more visual aspects of how I see is that since my eye has no pigment, which is the stuff that helps your eye filter some of the extra sunlight out from getting into your eye, because I have none of that, my eyes are more light sensitive than other people's. So I like my sunglasses, and sometimes I squint with bright lights, stuff like that. Another thing to consider about my vision is that I have nystagmus, which is the constant movement of your eyes all around to try and focus on something, but the catch is that they never do. So this, of course, leads to my vision being blurred. But a lot of people ask me, do you notice it constantly? Does it feel like an earthquake, like you're shaking or you're dizzy? And yes and no, like I'm used to it, but I don't constantly think about how dizzy or shaky or earthquakey I feel. Sometimes if someone were to ask me like, oh, focus on the camera, I'd notice that like my eyes are kind of darting around the room as I'm trying to do that. My depth perception and hand-eye coordination are not great, so I blame this on why I'm not a sporty gal and why I am super clumsy. I mean, like, I ice skated and swam, but the sports that, like, involved the throwing and catching of balls, just, like, moving objects coming at my face, the hand-eye coordination, the depth perception, like, wasn't there. I don't know when I'm going to put this in, but I also wanted to clear up that albinism is a different word from ableism, so just clearing that up.
I mean, but overall, like, me and albinism, you know, we're buds. You know, we're pretty cool. We figured it out. We figured out how to, like, coexist. We're making it work. And, of course, like, as life goes on, there's going to be things I have to deal with. But overall, I mean, I'm not mad at it. Congratulations. You've stayed to the end. So now, you get to hear me say all of the cliche YouTube things. Thank you for watching. Double thanks if you stayed to the end. Give this video a thumbs up if you like my face. Subscribe if you want to see more because I have more videos planned. And comment something if you have questions, comments, concerned, or tell me something you learned in this video. Also, follow me on Instagram at RealSamanthaHurley because one of these days I'm going to put a story tag thingy on my story and let people ask any questions they want. Fair game. And I will make a separate video with all the questions if I get enough of them. But that is all for today. I hope you have a great day. Hope you learned something. Happy Albinism Awareness Day, and bye.